Working remotely has gone from a casual need to a necessity. There are a lot of programs out there to help you access your computer. I'm going to show you the best one to use, and the best part about it, it's totally free. I'm Orman, aka the High Tech Nomad, and welcome. In this video, I'm going to show you how to install and use Google Remote desktops to access a computer remotely. Be sure to stay to the end of the video because I'm going to show you how to use any USB peripheral at home as if it was plugged into the remote computer. That means thumb drives, hard drives, and even webcams. So I've looked at all of the programs out there. When I say I've looked at all of them, I've looked at programs that you've probably never even heard of. Anybody out there remember PC Anywhere? If so, leave a comment below. So why do I like Google Remote desktops? It's easy to set up and use, you can use it anywhere, and it even supports things like cut, copy, and paste. It will work on a PC as well as a Mac, and they're cross-platform, so you can be on a PC and control a Mac, or vice versa. There also does not seem to be a limit to how many computers you can add to your account. It's super secure because it uses your Google account. So if you use a YubiKey, and if you're not familiar with that, you want to take a look at the video above. But if you use a YubiKey with your Google account, you basically have now locked down the ability for someone to access your computer remotely. And that's super important these days. Even if you don't use Google Chrome as your normal browser, you need to open it up and do this, but then you don't need to use it. In order to use the Google Remote desktop, you have to log in as you until you finish setting everything up. Then you can log yourself out. However, we'll still be able to access the computer. I'm going to go to sign in. Now it's going to ask me for my password. Because we have two-factor authentication, it's going to say, hey, you've got to put your security key in. So I do have my security key. So I can just go ahead and touch that, and that will go ahead and go through. Now we're logged into this machine. So now I'm going to say remote desktop.google.com/access. And scroll all the way down. Keep scrolling. And then you'll see where it says set up remote access. Go ahead and click on that. I'm going to go ahead and click on accept and install. You'll see it says it's going to go ahead and run that. It'll run it, and then it's going to ask me what we want to call this. I'm going to just call it ISL7. I'm going to click on next. It asks me to choose a PIN, and this is sort of a third layer because you're going to have your password. Then you're going, if you have a YubiKey key, you have your key, and then on top of that, you'll have this PIN. So I'm going to put my PIN in. I'm going to go ahead and click start. And it's going to go ahead and start that up in the background. And like I said, what's really great about this is once you have this set up, it is rock solid. It's not going anywhere. And now you see it says it's starting. And in a second, it'll be up and running. And it's that simple. Logged into my own browser. I'm going to put in the PIN that I created. I'm going to tell it to remember that one. So we'll go ahead and click on connect. And there we go. It's free, it's rock solid, and you can go anywhere and use this. Even though we had to load software on the other machine, you can go to any machine, and all you have to do is go to remotedesktop.google.com. We can use it on a Mac as well. It's the same thing. Just open that up so that you can run it, and after you run it, you're all set.
At the beginning of the video, I mentioned that there was a way that you could actually use your USB peripherals at home as if they were plugged into the remote computer. Virtual Here is a tremendous piece of software that allows you to extend your USB port to your remote computer. Once it's set up, you can plug any device into a USB port on the machine that you're at, and it will appear as though it is working on the remote computer. Be sure to share your remote working experience in the comments below.
Short video, but a timely one. We're going to be coming out with more and more. I'm doing YouTube full time at this point. please hit the like button. Please hit the subscribe button. Even more importantly, you know, we're on a totally different planet at this particular point. So let me know what things are important to you, what challenges you face. We had a whole bunch of videos about productivity and how to save time and how to get from work to home really, really quick. And obviously none of that means anything at this particular point. Please send your questions to questions@thehitechnomad.com. Until the next time, this is Orman Beckles, a.k.a. The High Tech Nomad, signing out.